Okay, good afternoon to all. One small recap, chapter number 1, electrostatistics. So first of all, what is electrostatistics? A study of charge at rest. It is the electrostatistics. So how many types of charge it is there? The charge is 2 types. One is a positive charge, another one negative charge. So what are the method of charging? Anybody tell me the method of charging? Any idea related to method of charging? Charge is 2 type, one is a positive, another one negative. Now my question, the method of charging. Charging by friction. Very good. Next, charging by friction, induction method, conduction. Very good. Induction, conduction, friction, and earthing also. So that is the method of charging. Very good. The value of E, that is 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. So based on that, the first one, Coulomb's law. So Coulomb's law states that the force of attraction or repulsion. Why they are saying force of attraction or repulsion means the 2 point charge is there. So this is positive and one more point also positive. So what is the nature between positive and positive? It is repel each other. So that is a force of repulsion. In case the point Q2 it is there, no? This Q2 is a negative. Then what about the entire force? That is the force of attraction. The force of interaction, that is attraction or repulsion between 2 point charges Q1 and Q2 in the free phase or vacuum is directly proportional to product of 2 point charges. That F value directly proportional to product. So product means multiple. So Q1 and Q2. And the F value inversely proportional to square of the distance. F value inversely proportional to square of the distance. So it will denote I need maximum number of force. Then I want to increase the value of charge and decrease the distance between the point. Then only I will get maximum force. So the directly proportional removing purpose, we add one constant, that is a k. The value of k, 1/4 πε₀. The value 9 × 10⁹ newton meter square, coulomb minus 2. The value is very important. Maybe they will ask one more question also. It is in the SI system. In CGS system, the value of k equal to 1. And what is epsilon naught? So epsilon naught means the permittivity of free phase. So what's the permittivity of free phase? Now we discuss, you know, in these 2 point charges Q1 and Q2. In this Q1 and Q2, it will permit certain values only, that permit of electric, that field only. We are saying that permittivity of free phase. So it is depends upon medium. For this free phase, the value is 8.85 × 10⁻¹² coulomb square newton inverse meter minus 2. So definitely you want to remember the values and remember the SI unit also. The epsilon naught SI unit, coulomb square newton inverse meter minus 2. Next, dielectric constant. So dielectric constant K or epsilon R, the formula permittivity of medium divided by absolute permittivity, and the value of K, see here in this side, the value of K, it is 1 for the minimum, for the vacuum. The K value nearly it is 1 for air. The K value infinity for the maximum. It is a unitless and there is no dimensional. So it is a just a constant for the conductor. So this is important. I think so it is not there in your book. Kindly take a notes. For the conductor, the value of K is maximum, the K is infinity, K is a unitless. Unitless means we can't say the proper unit like meter, length, time, ampere, like that. So there is no unit, there is no dimensional also. Please note this point, everyone. Okay, next day. The Coulomb's law in terms of electric constant. They are comparing with the force in vacuum divided by force in medium. The force in vacuum divided by force in medium, you will get K is equal to F divided by Fm. And Fm, that is the medium, the force in medium, it is equal to F divided by K. So the K is the dielectric constant. Next, this is very interesting sum. The identical charge, the Fg is equivalent to Fe. The force of gravity is equivalent to force of electrostatics. For the identical charges, then you can use in this formula. Q by M equal to root of 4 epsilon naught g. So capital G is referred universal gravitational constant. Universal gravitational constant. Please note in this formula also. Maybe they will ask one more question. Q by M equal to root of 4 pi epsilon naught g. Epsilon naught g 4 pi. It is a constant value. Q by M, only variable for Q by M. In case they are giving charge, electron means the charge of electron Q and the mass of the electron M. Shall I go to next?
Sir.
Okay.
Sir,
1 minute. No? So, what is 4 pi epsilon naught? It is a constant value. G also constant. Based on the sum, they will give charge and mass. In case they will ask any one thing, find the mass, otherwise, find the charge like that. Next, the electrostatic force are central forces in nature and it will obey the Newton's third law of motion. The force 1, 2, 2, it is equal to minus 2, 2, 1, the form of vector. In this diagram it is not there in your book, kindly note it. For the attraction and repulsion, the Coulomb's law in vector form. Derive the Coulomb's law in vector form. For the attractive means it is the unlike charges. Repulsive means like charges. The diagram alone you can draw. The vector form, F vector equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon q1 q2 by r square. into r cap. So r cap equal to modulus r vector divided by modulus of r vector. So this is the value of r cap. In this two diagram you can draw in your textbook itself. Kindly use the textbook, NCERT textbook.
Sir, why is breaking, sir?
Now it is okay. 1 minute, ma'am. 1 minute. Some network problem. This two diagram you can draw in your note or textbook alone. It is the force of attraction. This is the force of repulsion. And the r cap value, r vector divided by modulus of r vector. Coulomb's law obeys Newton's third law of motion.
Bubam sir.
So 1 minute, sir, 1 minute. Chapter number 1, accept Gauss law and applications of Gauss law. So reminder things, it is that you can prepare, it is based on board type of question. You can prepare for the year question, it is enough to get good marks. First you complete the year question, then we go for some advanced level for board. Next, so in this method of problem is important, ma. When the three point charges are placed at the corners of equatorial triangle as shown in the figure, like this, they will ask find the resultant force. So resultant force, the three also equal charges, wherever they are asking find the resultant force or the resultant electric field, means in class 11 you learn one formula, the resultant R is equal to root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. Okay, using this formula, finding the resultant force, resultant electric field, giving two different F1, F2, two forces, finding the resultant force means you can use this one. And generally for in this question the final format, it is a 60 degree, no, then you will get root 3 f. The f formula only q square divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. The formula for f, finally you will get resultant force, f is equal to root 3 F. What is F here? That is a Coulomb's law formula. 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 divided by R square. Q1 and Q2, everything is equal. So that Q square divided by R square. And 1 by 4 pi epsilon value also you know very well. Just apply the values and do the multiplication and the division. Finally, you will get the answer of the resultant force. Please note this one, ma. In case they are asking, they didn't given the force value, they are giving only the charge value, means you can use this one, q by 3 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square q1 square plus q2 square plus q1 q2. This is for competitive exam. No need for the board and all. For competitive, you can remember this one. And one electrostatic unit of charge, it is equal to one Franklin. Benjamin Franklin. If you have textbook, you can refer. This is important. One electrostatic unit, ESU, of charge, it is equal to one Franklin. Okay, this one completed. Next, to have same magnitude of force but both in vacuum and medium. Vacuum and medium, same magnitude of force, and F1 equal to F2, but F1 formula Q1 Q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square for the vacuum. F2 formula Q1 Q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught K R dash square. Then you will get R dash equal to R divided by root K. K denotes dielectric constant of medium. Please take a notes. Next, in this diagram, if fourth charge Q is placed at the centroid of equatorial triangle having three like charges, so like charges whether it is a negative or positive, there is no problem, and equal magnitude, the value also equal. For example, this is minus 2Q, means this is also minus 2Q, this is also minus 2Q. On vectors, okay, the all four charges remaining at the rest, then what about the centroid? In the center point, they are asking means Q is equal to minus Q divided by root 3. So this is a general formula for the centroid. Please note it. Along the statement, you can write, then only you can understand. In question paper also like this only come. Centroid of equatorial triangle. Draw the diagram and take a notes. Okay, so next one, this is important for board exam, or in this method, If two point charges Q1 and Q2 are separated by a distance r, then the distance d between the charge Q1 and the null point, underline the word null point, is given by, they are asking the null point. So null point means it is a balancing area. That is a d equal to r divided by root of Q2 divided by Q1 plus or minus 1. Now again, the condition Q2 is greater compared to Q1, it is in the like charges. So like charges means plus, unlike charges minus. And I think so, some students making, they know the formula. Maximum they are saying, sir, I know the formula, sir. But where to apply the formula? Which formula it will come for which sum? That is a maximum doubt. What is the reason means, just you are reading the formula only. You are not focusing on the terms. So this is the term. If the two point charges Q1 and Q2 are separated by a distance r, then the distance between d, the charges Q1 and null point, like that it is there, you want to use in this formula. And specific also there, in case the two charges also like charges. So like charges means plus, unlike charges minus. That also Q2 is greater. In charges they are given Q1, generally they will say one point is 20 coulomb, another point that is 15 coulomb, like that. You want to consider this is Q2, this is Q1, like that you should take, otherwise you will get wrong answer. So Q2 is a maximum compared to Q1. So everyone, when you are preparing for the competitive exam or board exam, you want to remember one thing, that statement with the formula. Diagram it is there means you want to compulsory remember. Diagram based question, definitely they will ask diagram based question, graphical based questions. Okay, this is next one. If four equal charges are placed at the vectors of a square as shown in the system in equilibrium. Okay, they are asking find the Q in this point. Then you can use this one. Q is equal to minus Q by 4, 1 plus 2 root 2. For like this new formula it is there, no need to prepare the derivation and all. Okay, they won't ask derivation. In your NCERT book, what are the derivation it is there, that derivation alone you can practice, it is enough first. So kindly give me some important for derivation, otherwise you feel very difficult. Okay, shall we go for next? Completed after that. Okay, next, electric field intensity or electric field strength or electric field. So electric field, it is the vector force per unit test charge, force experienced per unit test charge, it is electric field. E vector equal to 1 by 4, F divided by Q naught. Electric field due to a point charge. Okay, they are asking means E is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square into r cap. So r cap means it is a form of vector, and already you know very well the r cap. R cap equal to r vector divided by modulus of r vector. Anywhere you are writing the problem or any derivation, you are mentioning r cap means what is r cap? Inside you can mention r cap equal to r vector divided by modulus of r vector. So what is modulus of r vector? Some students have a doubt. Okay, I will tell you. So modulus of r vector means it is the root of the magnitude of individual value x square plus y square. They will give r vector equal to x I cap plus y j cap. Three coordinate it is there means x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. Finally you will get the magnitude. Magnitude means only the numerical value. So next one, this is for the two points, different point they are giving means, but in this graphical method, you can use this one, q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, r minus r dash cube, more or less. Normal subtraction only, x2 minus x1, like that, r minus r dash. RDA is it. Anywhere they are asking the resultant force or resultant electric field, like that means you can use the root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. Next, dipole. So dipole means a pair of equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance 2a. It is a dipole. The dipole formula p vector equal to q2a. The direction, the dipole direction is different. The direction negative to positive. The direction of dipole is negative charges to positive charges. And the derivation also you want to remember. Axial line or derivation it is there. Equatorial line one derivation it is there. The two derivation please prepare it, axial and equatorial. For the axial you will get E vector equal to p 2 p r divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square minus a square into that is a whole square for this formula. I am applying the condition of short dipole. Short dipole means that 2a it is a no, it is very very small value compared to r. So I will neglect a value. Finally I will get e vector equal to 2p divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r cube. 2 to 4 ma r power 4 will come. When this r cancelled means you will get e vector equal to 2p divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r cube. Next derivation, the final equation alone we are discussing now. Equatorial line or equatorial. The final equation E is equal to minus p divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square plus a square 3 by 2. This is 2p will come here, just p. And removing same for the short dipole, removing the a value, you will get E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught p divided by r cube. In this negative sign indicate the dipole moment is opposite direction of, otherwise anti-parallel of dipole, p cap, the vector, that is opposite, otherwise anti-parallel. This is a comparison between axial and the equatorial. E axial divided by E equatorial equal to 2 by 1. Next you want to concentrate on the torque, that problem. The torque acting on a electric dipole in uniform electric field. Torque related one derivation. that's Alma. So up to that you can prepare it. I will show you your book, what are the areas you want to cover, then we'll wind up the class. Introduction, electric charges. Next, conductor and insulator, charging by induction, the basic properties of charges. Coulomb's law in vector form. Next, force between multiple charges, electric field, electric field line and properties, electric dipole. For your point on the axis derivation, for the point on the equatorial plane derivation, I think so up to that enough. So I'll go for next topic. It is enough, but in this topic also you are taking up to 1.12. Give me reply, ma. If you want, okay, up to 1.12, you can prepare for test tomorrow. Test the portion. This is. Thank you so much for everyone.